So in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. And so, good morning, everyone. On behalf of the Poor Clares and myself, you're all very welcome to St. Clare's this morning. We gather for our 10 o'clock morning mass, but also this morning we gather to celebrate the Requiem Mass for Jean Florence Bulger. So we gather to welcome her home back here to Great Cullen again, but also to commend her now to our new home in heaven. So today we thank God for her long life. We draw inspiration from it, and we do celebrate it as well. We gather to offer the support of our love and prayers to her family, Christine, Michael, Maria, Karen, Angela, and David, and her 19 grandchildren, her 35 great-grandchildren, and her 6 great-great-grandchildren. So 5 generations, and we have. We also think and pray for our son-in-law, Ger, and Michael's partner, Hanke, and Angela's partner, John. And then all of the in-laws, nephews, nieces, cousins, extended family, neighbours and friends. We pray today that God will give you comfort and strength. Welcome all those who can't be here but are joining us via our parish webcam. I'd like to welcome in a very special way from London, Mag O'Brien, who sent in an email this morning asking me to convey her sympathies and condolences to Christine, Michael, Maria, Karen, Angela and David. And she says, "My heart is fully broken for all of you. Your mammy was a lady, a gentle, kind and loving soul. I was blessed with all the love and understanding she gave me throughout my life, especially as a child. And I'm thankful that I could be a tiny part of her life. My thoughts and prayers are with you all today. Jean, may you rest in eternal peace. Amen." So there's a message there, and I know many more messages on the Book of Consolences and RIP to people who can't be here. So we think of them, and we are united very much in prayer and in faith. Jean herself, too, had a lovely, simple faith. She liked to pray. She believed in the resurrection. She knew that when this day come, she would be going back to God. And we take comfort from the Book of Scriptures, which I now place on her coffin, because in that Book of Scriptures, there's wonderful words of hope and consolation. So in life, she cherished the gospel of Jesus. May Christ greet her now with the words of eternal life. Come, blessed of my Father. Also, some of our family are going to bring up some symbols now to place on the table there beside her coffin as symbols to represent her life. She had a great love of knitting, and Christine is going to bring up some of our samples of her knitting to place it there on the table. Thank you. And Angela will bring up a picture of some of the needlework that she did as well. Place it on the table. Thank you. Karen is going to bring up a family photograph expressing her great love for all her family. And she had a great love of dogs and her recent dog, Lucy. So Alan will bring up a photograph of Jean with Lucy. So some of the symbols that represent her life that we have come to celebrate today. Welcome anyone else who have joined us too to remember their loved ones at this Mass. So friends, we believe that all the ties of friendship and affection which knit us as one throughout our lives do not unravel with death. Confident that God always remembers the good we do and forgives any failures, we now pray asking God to gather Jean Florence to himself. Lord, in our grief we turn to you. Are you not the God of love who open your ears to all? Listen to our prayers for your servant whom you have called from this world. Lead her now to your kingdom of light and peace. Count her among the saints in glory. We ask you this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated now again, everyone. And Michael is going to read the first reading. The Poor Clares were going to lead us then in the responsorial psalm. And Rachel will read the second reading.
Psalm A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the virtuous are in the hands of God. No torment shall ever touch them. In the eyes of the unwise, they did appear to die. Their going looked like disaster. They are leaving us like annihilation. But they are in peace. God has put them to the test and proved them to be worthy with him. He has tested them like gold in a furnace and accepted them as a holocaust. When the time comes for his visitation, they will shine out. They will trust in him, will understand the truth. Those who are faithful will live with him in love. For grace and mercy await those who he has chosen. The word of the Lord.
Reading from the first letter of St. John. Think of the love that the Father has lavished on us by letting us be called God's children, and that is what we are. Because the world refused to acknowledge him, therefore it does not acknowledge us. My dear people, we are already the children of God, but what we are to be in the future has not yet been revealed. All we know is that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, because we shall see him as he really is. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
So please stand to greet the gospel.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I am going now to prepare a place for you, and after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ.
I invite you to be seated for a few moments as we reflect on that lovely gospel story that we have just heard. Lovely comforting words that Jesus speaks to his disciples just before he departs. He knows that they are going to be sad because it's a natural feeling to be sad when you lose somebody that is close. But he's saying to them not to let their hearts be troubled, but they are to trust in God and trust in him. He's saying the same too to Jean's family and all of us today. Place our trust in him. Don't let our hearts be troubled. He's reminding us that there are many rooms in his Father's house, and he's going there to prepare a place for us. He's describing heaven as a place with many rooms. In other words, like a home. And it's lovely to know that when we die, that we have a home ready for us in the heavens. And so today, as we celebrate Jean Florence's Requiem Mass, we think of the various homes that she had in this life. They were all places where she herself gave and received love. We think of our first home in Sale, in Manchester. We think of her being born in 1932, and we think of her parents, Philip and Alice, and her brothers, Philip and Raymond. And that was her first home. And there she received love and gave love and experienced the importance of family and the importance of faith and being a neighbour. And then in her early years, she would work as a shop assistant. She loved to cycle to the beach with her friend Irene. And then Mike Bulger came over here from Grey Cullen, from Carlow, over to England to work. And they met up and were engaged and married within 6 months. So a real whirlwind romance. And they married in 1956. And they made their home for the first few years of married life in Sale in Manchester. And then they moved over to Ireland in 1962. And Jean Florence Davis, as she was originally, was born and baptized into the Church of England faith, but she was welcomed and confirmed into the Catholic faith soon after she coming back to Ireland. And they lived in 11 Church Street with Mike's parents for a few years, and then they moved to 5 Church Street up the hill, and they lived there for 28 years. And there's where they reared their family. They moved to Kellistown then in 1991. But a very important part of any home, and particularly the homes where Jean lived, was the important role that a loving wife and a loving mother always had. And she was that loving mother who cared for her children, her husband, and in later years, the grandchildren and the great-grandchildren that she loved so dearly as well. And we know, too, the importance of a mother in the home doing the knitting. And she was very, very gifted as a dressmaker and would knit the jumpers for the children and the dresses for the girls and all sorts of things as well. She cooked as well. Her Irish stew was something special. Her shepherd's pie, too, which was so important. Then the cream cakes, which I think she used to burn on a few occasions as they would experience and see the smoke coming out of the oven when the cream cakes would be on. But there's the things that mothers do. And then to the lovely holidays that they experienced, the family holidays to Coratloe in their caravan. And then Mike would row the boat up the Barrow, up to Knockbeg with Jean and the family in it, and they would swim there in the weir in Knockbeg and have their picnic. She loved, too, walking her dogs, and dogs was always a big part of the home where Jean lived. She always had a dog in the house, and always the Jack Russells. And again, we mentioned earlier her last dog, Lucy, which she was so deeply fond of as well. She also, too, had time to do other things besides being a mother to her family and a granny and a great-granny and a great-grand-granny. She liked her bingo. She loved to read, too. She loved her true stories and her romance stories, stories about family gatherings, which was important to her as well. She loved her music. Mike Denver and Elvis were some of the stars that she enjoyed as well. And so she did live life and live it to the full, and home was important to her. Then a number of years ago, when she broke her hip, she was never really the same. And I suppose they knew that in the last couple of years, in the last few weeks and months, she was beginning to go downhill as she lived out in Kellistown with her son David. And we know too that her little dog Lucy knew too that she was dying as Lucy sat with her during her final hours before she died. Jesus said that when you die, you won't be dying alone. In that gospel story, he says, I will come back and I will bring you to your place. That's comforting to know too, that Jesus will always come back for us and bring us to our home in heaven. And she did go holding the hand of Jesus. Jesus reminds us too in that gospel that he is the way to that place. I am the way and the truth and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me. And faith was important to Jean too. A very religious person in her own way would say her prayers every night, always pray for the whole family, and always had people in our thoughts and in our prayers. Great devotion to Saint Gerard, and would do the novena to him on a regular basis. So she knew, because of her faith in Jesus, that she was on her way to God, to that place where Jesus has made ready for her, that place with many rooms, that new home. And during her life too, she did experience sadness, the sadness of losing Mike a number of years ago, and also two little babies, Susan, Jean, and Jeanette Clare, and also again her parents and her brothers, and they are all now reunited again in God's kingdom. The first reading reminds us the souls of the virtuous are in the hands of God. While they're going from us seems a disaster annihilation, we know they are now at peace. And we celebrate the peace that Jean is now enjoying in heaven. And so eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and lay perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. Amen. So now please stand. I'm going to invite Anne-Marie to lead us in the prayers of the faithful.
Nanny Jean touched the lives of us all. Help us to keep her alive in our lives, the values and the ideals she put before us. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
God of all consolation, help us to comfort one another in our grief, finding light in time of darkness and faith in time of doubt. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray in thanksgiving for our neighbours and friends who have been so kind to us during this time of sadness. May God reward their kindness and bless their homes with happiness and peace. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all those whose lives are dedicated to caring for the sick, and in particular, we pray for the doctors, nurse, chaplain, and the staff of Home Health Hospital, and to her son David, who cared for Nanny Jean during her illness. May God reward their goodness and kindness. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Thanks, Anne-Marie. And we also remember in our prayers this morning the repose of the soul of Mary Patricia MacDonald, Clonmore Collision, whose anniversary occurs at this time. We also again remember in our prayers too the people of Ukraine at this time, and we pray for them that God will give them strength and courage, and we pray for peace in that country and in the world. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously.
So, Lord, may you support us all day long till the shadows lengthen and evening falls and the busy world is hushed, the fever of life is over and our work is done. Then, in your mercy, Lord, grant us a safe lodging, a holy rest, and peace at last. Amen. We make our prayer now to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. Now we're going to continue with the offertory of our Mass. I'm going to invite Taylor, John, and Idel now to bring to the altar the gifts of bread and wine. Pray now, friends, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good.
As we humbly present to you these offerings for the salvation of Jean, your friend, we beseech your mercy that she who never doubted Jesus to be a loving Saviour may now find a warm welcome. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Let
us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone he accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying. As one he chose to die, so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we now proclaim. And so you are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took the bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his friends, and he said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In the same way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, gave it to his friends, and he said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins." Then he said, "Do this in memory of me." So now we proclaim together in song the mystery of our faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Dennis, our Bishop, and all people. Remember Jean, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that Jean, who was united with your son in a death like his, may now be one with him in resurrection. Remember all our sisters and brothers who we gather to remembrance at our Mass today, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on all of us, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life. We may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. And so we pray through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours forever and ever. So now we stand as we pray to a loving, caring Father. We pray to God for strength and courage, peace and acceptance this day as we pray the prayer Jesus gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be free from sin, safe from all worries, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
So now the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
So now, just for a few moments, maybe we'll just again make peace, wave at those around us, but we'll just again pause for a moment as we pray for peace in Ukraine and in the world, as we think of the peace that only Jesus can give, his special gift. Pray, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. I invite you now to kneel as we prepare for receive communion. This is Jesus. This is his body and his blood. This is Jesus who is saying to us today to trust in him, to not to be afraid. This is Jesus who went back to heaven to prepare a place for all of us. This is Jesus who is the way to that place. Happy are we now to be called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Let perpetual light shine upon her with all your saints forever, for you are rich in mercy. For communion, I would like to receive, invite, there will be a minister down at the communion station towards the back. Those in the centre, again, I invite you to come up two lines up the centre and go back the sides. There will be a minister also covering the two side aisles as well. So now I invite Maria to come up to speak.
Mammy, my beautiful mammy, the English rose, a true lady. I have never known a superwoman, but I do now. Mammy, you are my hero. You are everything I wish for in a mother, and more. Your smile lit up a room. You have a certain presence about you. You are royalty, Mammy. You are our queen. You have truly inspired us, and we will always be proud of our Mammy, our grandmother, our great-grandmother, and our great-great-grandmother, 5 generations of this beautiful lady. Mammy has many beautiful qualities. Her gift of knitting was one of them. Many a time you would see Mammy knitting away in her chair. Mammy's English roots was very important to her. Mammy was well-spoken. She spoke very softly, but by God, when she gave out, she knew all about it. Mammy always took great pride in her appearance. Her skin was so soft and smooth, she hadn't even got a wrinkle. She used to say, well, you only have one face, you have to look after it. And she also loved her clothes. When we were younger, Mammy would throw us a little birthday party, and she put on a lovely little spread. Yes, those banana sandwiches, they were yum. One time, Daddy came home and Mammy was cooking. Mike, she says, you're going to be very proud of me. I'm cooking the turkey. Did you clean it out and stuff it? No, Mike, sure, it was already stuffed. Sure, what had Mammy done? She only had left the giblets in it. Daddy said, well, it was the most moist and tender turkey he had ever tasted. And when Mammy used to try out a recipe, well, you know what? We'd be eating it for a week. One time, when England and Ireland was playing a match, we were all in the boat club, and England scored a goal, and Mammy jumped up with excitement. Well, she was the only English person in the boat club. When Mammy walked, she never lifted her feet. She used to do the shuffle like a penguin. Mammy loved music, Dickie Rock among them. And she would sing along when the song was playing. She often sang the song Love Letter Straight from the Heart, a beautiful version of it. Mammy, we will always remember you as a loving, caring mother. The best any child could wish for. So all I say now is rest easy and sleep well. Until we meet again, your loving daughter. Rest in peace, Mammy. We'll miss you, and now we are with Daddy finally.
So now I invite you to please stand for our concluding prayer. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for our journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Jean Florence may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
So on behalf of Jean's family, to thank you all for your prayers and support. I know you'll continue to keep them in your prayers over the days and months ahead. Thanks to the Poor Clares for their singing, and also to Jean's granddaughter, Mary Jean, who did the first piece and will also do the concluding piece as well. Thanks to all our readers, our gift bearers, our Eucharistic ministers and our stewards. Thank you to Mark Carpenter, his staff, and Catherine, our sacristan here, and all who minister in any way at our Mass this morning. So now the Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
So now we pray our farewell prayers for Jean. Before we go our separate ways, we take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet Jean again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. We want to bless her coffin now with holy water as a reminder of her baptism. That was the day she received the promise of heaven for the first time, the day she began her Christian journey, the day she took Jesus as her friend. And it was the day, too, she received the promise of everlasting life. We also incense her beautiful body to show our reverence for the human body as a dwelling place of God's Spirit. But the soul is now risen to God like the smoke from the incense. So we pray in silence. Response is, receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Saints of God, come to her aid. Come to meet her, angels of the Lord.
Receive her soul and present her to God.
May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to Abraham's side.
Receive her soul and present her to God.
Eternal rest grant unto Jean, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. And so we pray, into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We thank you for the many blessings you gave her in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to Jean, and help us who remain here to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ, and we are with you and with Jean forever. Amen. Peace now, we take Jean to her place of rest. Amen.